Hi everyone, I'm J.D. Hoovener, your host of the Bold Today Show, where you, the inventor, entrepreneur, or business owner, get your daily dose of inspiration to make the world a better place. Today we've got a challenge for you. We've been talking about the USPTO and policy for the past couple days. And if you haven't had a chance, go back and listen to those. They're quick, and they'll help you get a sense as far as what the latest direction has been over the USPTO. So today, if you're involved in patents at all, what I want you to do is put in the comments below, what's one thing that has always been unclear to you and has been a mystery about? You know, if you can't find it on the USPTO.gov website, you've been scratching your head, put down below what you think should be done to fix if there's a solution to our patent situation. And a second part, we got a kind of a pop quiz question for you. How many USPTO examiners would you say are there in the United States? Put down that in the comments below. The person that's the closest, without cheating, will win a prize. All right, so today we're going to talk about many countries coming together to form parts of not only a treaty, but actually a working relationship in trying to come up with and improve international patent reform, international patent strength. There's an interesting group called IP5. IP5. It's made up of the five biggest patent offices in the world. It's the US, Japanese, Korean, European Patent Office, and the Chinese Patent Office. So those, the biggest five patent offices in the world, are currently getting together and solving problems related to international patent rights. Right now they're tackling three. The first one they're working on right now is about classifications. And we've talked about classifications a little bit, but it's important to note that each invention, technology area, is classified. And within the U.S., there's, of course, the U.S. has its own classification system in determining, you know, what art unit, which examiner will be assigned to this invention, and how do we technically classify this invention? And of course, you know, over the years, many different countries have had their own classification systems. And so IP5 is now going through this arduous process to come up with a unified classification system and make sure that when I file my patent initially in the US and then want to seek those rights overseas, let's say in China, that those classifications will actually match. It matters quite a bit in terms of the technology being examined to speed up and hopefully make things more efficient. When that examiner gets it in China, they'll be able to look at and recognize that search and examination done in the US and other jurisdictions. The other area that IP5 is looking at, which is quite interesting, is the prosecution history and the docket. It's quite revealing to a later filing country, you know, much like, you know, the European Patent Office, if they can look at and see what the examiner did and what amendments were made to that application as it was proceeding. So a lot of cool things that IP5 is working on. We're going to put the URL over here so you can check out what they're up to as of late. It's really neat seeing these countries come together, realizing that patent rights certainly exist in the international domain, and there needs to be a way to unify that to reduce the overall workload. I'm your host, J.D. Hoovener of the Bold Today Show. Hope you all had a wonderful time today. If you have any other questions at all or wanted to follow up, please see our website and contact information on the next page. We're at boldpatents.com. We give away free 30-minute consultations to the right people that have questions and that want to know more about how to move their product forward into the marketplace. Have a wonderful day. Go big, go bold.
Go big, go bold at boldip.com.